Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can use a profile and permission set in Salesforce. Before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and there you will find links of various playlists related to Salesforce videos, so you can follow them. So now first I'm going to explore profile for you and then we will discuss about the permission set. So if you go into your org and click on the setup and search for profile, so under user option, profile will be available and you will see various profiles listed here. So if your profile is standard, then this custom checkbox will be unchecked. And if your profile is custom, like you cloned existing profile and created new one, so this checkbox will be there. And you can delete those profiles, those are created by you. But the standard profiles you won't be able to delete. You can just clone them and create new one, right? And let me clone a particular profile so that we can create a new profile. So normally whenever we clone a particular profile, so we pick standard user profile. So I'm going to clone this one. So here you can see existing profile is standard user, its user license is Salesforce, and I need to provide new profile name. So demo standard user profile. So I'm clicking on save. So remember that user license is also important. So whatever you can control through profile, that also depends upon the license that you choose for a particular profile. So now you can see demo standard user profile is created. It is a custom profile. And now you can restrict various permissions with the help of this profile. And also you can delete this profile because it is a custom profile. If you want to assign a particular users for this profile, so you can click on view users. And if you want to assign new user, you can click here. If you want to add multiple users, you can click here. For resetting the password for some users, you can select those users and click on this button, right? So remember that whenever we create users in Salesforce, we need to assign a particular profile to that user. So now if I move, so let me open setup in one more tab so that I can take you to the user record. So in setup, you can type a user and click on users. So all available users will be listed and you can create new users as well as per the limits of your org. So here you can see every user is associated with a particular profile. And if you try to create new user, then also you need to select a particular profile. So first, you need to select the license and accordingly your profile will be available. So identity user license, this profile is available. If you select any other, let's say Salesforce platform, so this profile is available. So accordingly your profiles will be listed here, right? And if I open, so let's say I am editing this user. So here user license is Salesforce. So here you can see a demo standard user profile. So in demo org, we can create only two users and I already created two users with Salesforce license. So that's why I am not able to create new user with Salesforce user license. So that's why I edited existing users so that we can view that profile, right? So this way you can associate a particular user with a profile. So remember that one user can be associated with one profile, but like if you have 10 users and you want to assign single profile to all those 10 users, then that is possible. But one user can have only one profile. Now, if we move to this profile, so now we need to understand what we can do with the profiles. So you can apply console setting, you can apply page layout setting for each standard objects as well as custom objects. So these are custom objects. So you can click on a particular object like view assignment and you can control the assignments for this particular profile for layouts, right? So you can control page layouts for different objects through profile. Then you can apply field level security. So if you want to restrict like this profile, users won't be able to access a particular field related to particular object, then you can do that as well. So you need to click on this view. So here you can see we can control read access and edit access. So click on edit and accordingly you can check or uncheck the check boxes as per the requirement. So click on back to profile so that we can apply other settings as well. So you can apply field level security for standard objects as well as for custom objects. Then you can control custom app settings, like which apps will be visible for this profile user and which app will be default accessible. So this is default sales app and others are visible. These are not visible. Then service provider access, then tab setting. So you can control this as well. Then record type setting you can control. Then administrative permissions. So these are various permissions that you can give or you can revoke access. Then we have general user permissions. Then we have standard object permissions. Then we have custom object permission. So right now you can see we can't edit these permissions. So for that you need to click on edit so that those will be available for editing. So click on edit. So now your profile is in edit mode. So you can change custom app settings. You can change tab settings. So tab settings are three: tab and tab, default off and default on. So accordingly you can choose. If you choose default on, so it will be available on the tab. Like here, tab will be visible. If you select default off, so it won't be available on the navigation bar, but still you can access the tab. But if you select tab hidden, so it won't be available on navigation bar and you won't be able to access that tab. So if you directly want to access the tabs, those are not available on the navigation bar. So you can search for them here. Like if you want to open report, so you can search it here as well. But if you selected tab hidden, then that tab won't be searchable. So this is tab setting, then administrative permission you can control, then general user permission you can control, then this is standard object permission, so you can give or revoke the permissions, then custom object permissions, then desktop integration, clients, session settings, password policies. So these things you can control with the help of profiles. Now, if we move to down again, then various more permissions you can control. So login hours you can control, login IP ranges. You can control which Apex class can be accessible by the users of this profile, which VF pages can be accessible, data source access, external data source access, enabled name credential access, custom metadata type access, custom setting definition access, enable flow access, enable service presence status access, enable custom permissions, default community. So these things you can control with help of this profile. And let's say you have provided some restrictions on this profile and you assigned this profile to certain users, but now you want to give additional permissions to specific users only. So let's say your profile is assigned to 10 users. And out of those 10 users, you want to give additional permission to 2 users only. So in that case, permission set comes in picture. So if you want to add on permissions for specific users, then after assigning the profile, you can assign permission sets to those specific users as well. So for that, you need to search permission set. And here you can see various permission sets are already available. If you want to create new one, so you can do that as well. So demo permission set for specific users. You can put the description, you can choose the license accordingly and click on save. And here you can put the permissions, respective permission like app related connected apps, object setting, app permission, Apex class, Visual Force. So accordingly you can put the permission. So let's say I want to give additional permission for objects. So I can come here, click on object, and I can click on edit. And I can check whatever permission I want to give. So above you can see object permission and then you can see field permission. So remember that through permission set, you only plus the permission. You cannot minus the permission. Those are already available on the profile. So the permissions which are already available on the profile, user can use those permission. If you assign any permission set to that user, then profile permissions plus permission set permissions will be available to that user. So don't think that if you uncheck the checkbox, so this permission won't be available to that user. It is not like that. So profile plus permission set, not profile minus permission set. So remember this. And after assigning particular permission, let's say I'm giving this permission, so I can click on save. And after saving this, you can assign this permission set to a particular user. So you can click on here, manage assignment, and you can click on add assignments and select a particular user. So let's say I'm selecting this user and I'm clicking on assign and clicking on done. So this way, this permission set is assigned to this user. So back to permission set, and if I click on manage assignment, so now you can see this permission set is assigned to this user, right? So this way you can assign permission sets to particular user. So we can assign one profile to one user, but you can assign any number of permission set to a user, right? So this is the difference between profiles and permission sets. Now, if you want to change the view of this profile, so here you can search for user management settings, and from here you can enable enhance profile user interface. So you can check this. Now again I am moving to profiles. And I'm going to open this one demo standard user profile that we created, and you will see a different view here. So here you can see, right? So this you can control with this permission. So again, I am showing that user management setting. From user management setting, you can control this enhance profile user interface. So if you uncheck this and if you refresh this page, so you will see different view of the profile. So sometimes you also need this so that you can have different views of the profile. So whatever you like, you can change it from here. So this is all about profiles and permission sets. So concluding my explanation now. So we can assign one profile to one user. We can control permissions through profiles. And if you want to give additional permissions to particular users, then you can create permission sets. And we can assign any number of permission sets to a particular user. So this is all about profiles and permission sets. And these are important because we control org, we control objects, we control field level security, we control standard permission or administrative permissions with the help of profiles and other things as well. So explore this in your org so that you can understand how we can use profiles and permission sets in better way. Thank you for watching this video.